It's the National Football League on EA Sports. And if it's in the game, it's in the game. It's the Carolina Panthers and the Washington Commanders. And it comes your way next on Madden Football.
We are approximately 5 miles east of Washington, D.C., and that's where you find this place, Commanders Field in Landover, Maryland.
Brandon Gaudin and Charles Davis on hand. Kickoff just moments away. Charles, quickly, keys to the game.
For me, it's coaching. Who prepared his team the best going into this one to give them the confidence to believe that they would win the game? That's who's going to come out of this one on top.
Here's the former Florida Gator, Eddie Pinheiro, to get us started.
And off we go in our nation's capital. And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28.
And we get a stoppage because, as you can see, a member of the Commanders in some obvious discomfort. Well, now they're going to come out and take a look at this injury, and we'll be back in a moment.
They go play action. Daniels. Open man is Noah Brown.
And they nearly get this all the way to midfield. Mark him down at the 49.
A good pickup there, 21 yards.
Certainly no settling into the drive there. They came right out on the first play and attacked the middle of the field for a big gainer and a first down.
And they'll let the quarterback keep it here on first and 10. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line.
The decision to keep it turns out to be a good one. 11 yards in the first down.
That may be a sneak peek on this opening drive of what this young rookie can showcase, his legs.
And normally, as you start a game, you're just thinking, can he get the snap? Can he hand off? Can he just execute? Instead, he doesn't waste any time on wrapping another dimension to his game, showing off those wheels and picking up some nice yardage.
And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. The escapability in evidence there is that one good for 15 and a first.
As we both know, there was a lot that went into why they made him their first round pick this year. Part of it was what they saw in college, his playmaking ability when things break down. As soon as he saw he wasn't getting a lane to throw, he pivoted and found an alternate way to the marker.
From the shotgun, it's Daniels.
Complete to Zacchaeus. And they'll work it inside the 15-yard line before it's all said and done. Back-to-back nice plays, 12 yards that time and a first down.
Pretty solid opening drive here, Charles. They've worked in the run game, the pass game, just steadily getting yards, and now they've got it inside the red zone here with an opportunity.
And the only thing they don't have so far is points. But the way that they're moving the ball now, that shouldn't take much longer. And they've established a great...
And he's in. Touchdown, Commanders. Austin Ekeler.
A 13-yard touchdown run.
And the Commanders are on the board first here this afternoon.
And they do exactly what they wanted to. Opening drive, they get into the end zone, they do it on the ground.
And not only is the person lugging the ball happy, of course, because he got it into the end zone. How about the offensive linemen and receivers who are blocking for him? They have to feel great about themselves, sticking in the end zone on a running play.
Austin Seibert on for the extra point.
And the kick is good, and the Commanders out to a 7-0 lead.
The drive summary that time, 5 plays.
And it's Austin Ekeler who finishes things off with a touchdown run.
following the touchdown. Here's Seibert now to kick it off. Oh, a good return up past the 30. And all in all, a pretty solid return. Nearly got it to the 35. They'll mark him down officially at the 34.
So here are the Panthers now for their opening drive. They'll be led out by the former Texas Christian University Horned Frog, Andy Dalton.
If your team is in a pinch, there aren't many quarterbacks who can bail you out like the Red Rifle. He not only brings a ton of experience to any quarterback room, but he's a perfect mentor who can help a young quarterback as he goes through the maturation process. But often when he gets his number called and he gets on the field, his team feels very comfortable with him under center.
They'll start on the ground with Hubbard.
And he'll rumble for about five, up close to the 40.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
Ball on the 39. Here's second down and five. And he'll go again here with Hubbard.
And he is going to be stopped cold behind the line of scrimmage. A loss on that play, and now third down gets tougher. Third and six.
That was well played there defensively. Two tight ends in the formation, which essentially gave them seven blockers up front. Hard to imagine with all that size and beef that they could let a tackler through, but that's exactly what happened. A loss resulted.
In motion right is Mingo.
Third down from the gun, Dalton.
That to the right sideline, and it falls incomplete.
That was their first third down try of the game, and clearly something was off in the execution of that play. Good news, they've got a whole game left to clean that up and start clicking on those key third down throws.
So on fourth down, here's Johnny Hecker to punt it away. Fair catch signaled for and taken at about the 15-yard line. So a change of possession here on the punt.
And it will be Washington football now with a first and 10. Here's Daniels. Got a man. It's the rookie out of the third round.
And he works it across the 25 before being tackled. A gain of 11 to kick off the drive, and it's a quick first down.
Well, as a coach, you absolutely love seeing your offense find their rhythm early, and that's exactly what we've seen so far. They had a touchdown on their opening drive, and now they connect here for another nice gain for a first down. This offense is moving the ball well, exactly as he drew it up in practice.
First carry of the game for Brian Robinson.
And just no chance of turning the corner. He can only get back to the line of scrimmage. Second and 10 coming up. Looked like he was trying to bounce it outside, but no success.
Yeah, sometimes you got to just figure out where you're going to go, and sometimes you just have to take it to another spot. And trying to get it outside, the defensive pursuit was there and just ran him down.
Off the play fake, Daniels. And that one into the hands of Brown downfield. And he has a big gain inside the 40 before being dropped.
It's a gain of 35.
There's the arm strength that we saw in college and during the scouting process. And really, it's not just the arm strength there, but the placement as well. To me, that was an excellent combination of arm talent and accuracy.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 38.
Option play, here's Robinson.
And he'll take this ahead for about four. Second down coming up.
Some of the most unselfish players on any football team, defensive tackles, because we ask them to just eat up blocks and allow other people to make tackles. But when he can make a play himself, as we just saw there, that's a big day.
To throw is Daniels. pressure comes in. He's brought down. It's a Panther sack. Jadeveon Clowney buries him for a loss of 11 from his outside linebacker spot.
Yeah, some real defensive resistance there, saying not so fast to a good drive. They had marched to the end zone the last time out.
So a tough situation to overcome here. Third and 17. Now Daniels. He's going to let this go for the end zone. And he knocks the ball away and it falls incomplete.
I spotted man coverage on the outside. I expect we'll see a lot of that from this defense as this game moves on. And that was a good job there as that one was knocked away.
So on fourth down, Washington going to call on Tress Way to punt it away. And no return here. Where will they spot it? They say just outside the 20-yard line. The Panthers coming back out onto the field for their second drive. The crowd may be losing just a little bit of the edge after back-to-back punts.
They want some big plays. They want to see some offense. They want to see somebody break away, whether it's through the air or on the ground. Now it'll be interesting to see where the patience is on both sides. Each head coach, can you hang in there and not try and force something that could put your team in some jeopardy?
And nothing much materializing there on the first down run. He'll get a couple and that's it.
Well, any lane that might have been open there was closed pretty quickly, and that was because the defensive front, they won that battle at the point of attack at the line of scrimmage. They used great leverage, held their spot, and stacked him up.
In motion left here, one of their tight ends. Here's Dalton. That's the rookie first-round pick, Xavier Leggett. And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. Give him 18. It's a Carolina first down.
And that's a more than acceptable read right there because it's zone coverage, so timing is everything. This time he waits for his man to come open, puts it right on him, and they pick up a first down.
Dalton now to pass. He's got his tight end. It's Tommy Tremble.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
From the 48-yard line, here's second and three. So Dalton now. Over the middle, complete. It's Hubbard. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 42. It's a 10-yard pickup, and that's enough to move the chains. After one, 7-0 on EA Sports. Panther football to start quarter number two as they've got it with a first and 10. On the counter, this is Hubbard. And they'll get him down after a pickup of 8, second and 2.
Offensive linemen love creating space for their guys carrying the ball, but when that guy also breaks tackles and creates extra yardage, they almost feel like he's one of them, and they really embrace him.
Now a second and 2. Right back to Hubbard. And this time not quite to the 30. It'll be down at the 31-yard line. They'll get 3 as the drive continues. It's a first down.
I think they like this drive a little bit better there, partner. Running game helping out, picking up some of the slack. Because remember the last drive, they went 3 and out.
Line of scrimmage, the 31 now on first and 10. Straight ahead with Hubbard. And he can only manage to get a couple. Second and 8 coming up.
Certainly a nice job there by the defense rallying to the football and getting him on the ground, but I think the play gets made by the defensive front, because if they can't get upfield, their job is to go ahead and get low, almost get into a ball sometimes, stack things up, and make it difficult for the runner to find a hole.
And now to the air, Dalton. He'll dump this one off to Hubbard. A minimal gain there on the 8th play of the drive.
And we see another pitch and catch there to the running back. This position just continues to evolve. They become just as critical to the passing attack as a lot of receivers, tight ends, because their ability to make people miss in the open field can really generate big plays for an offense.
In motion right is Mingo.
Out of the gun, it's Dalton. And he's going to go down here, a sack. They push him back to the 34. Credit that sack to Dante Fowler Jr.
So not only do you not get the first down, but you've also made things a lot more difficult on your field goal kicker.
Yeah, they're still in range, but you're exactly right, because you know the kicker's over there saying, thanks a lot, you just made my job a little tougher, because when he kicks it now, he'll kick it lower because he's got to get more distance. That means there's more jeopardy for the ball to get tipped or blocked.
This is up and good from Pinheiro.
And they are on the board, but still trailing. It's 7-3.
So they're able to end that drive with 3 points in this one possession ball game.
And ideally, you want to end every drive with points. Most quarterbacks would tell you, let's end it with a kick, right? A PAT, that's number one. Field goal, you'll take. Punts, you really don't want to do that. In this case, they'll take the field goal and get prepared for the rest of the game.
After the field goal, on to kick it away is Pinheiro.
And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Washington offense set to take over again. Obviously not the intended goal last drive. They had to punt the football, but still, they've got the lead here and now a chance to add on to that lead if they can get points on this drive. First and 10 upcoming.
They start on the ground with Robinson here. And only able to get two here. Stopped at the 30.
Oh, that's a real nice job there by the defensive front. They just engaged and held their ground. But how about the guy who made the play? We often talk about whether they take a good first step or not. Many times you just don't take any step. Just get your feet moving, get your body going. And then once he made the read, he was able to make the play.
Checks this one down to Robinson.
It looks like, yes, it is. 6 defensive backs on the field for Carolina.
They're going with a dime set.
To the air goes Daniels.
And he will slide to a stop. He does have the first down. A good pickup there, a 22.
Certainly not a positive sign if you're the D coordinator and you see your guys give up that space so early in the game. Third down, that's when the clamps are supposed to come out. But his ability to create things with his legs makes things difficult.
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 at the 45-yard line.
A give left side to Robinson.
He's going to go out of bounds, but he takes this one down just shy of the 20. That's back-to-back plays of over 20 yards.
Well, partner, I have to say they caught him in the right defense there. Nickel set, 5th defensive back on the field, and they love to run against that because now you typically get a bigger blocker on a smaller defender.
Yeah, because those DBs like you, they want the interception. They're not as worried about the running play, right?
Not at all. And I still remember being in school, and one of my offensive line teammates used to say, boy, I'd love to come downfield and hit you little people.
Good run there. A good pickup there, 21 yards.
It's all pretty simple sometimes, isn't it? go where the defenders are not, and he does exactly that. Makes a nice catch to move the chains. Defense got to find a better way of accounting for the shorter routes that are being run against them.
Play action, now it's Daniels.
And he fends him off. Feeling the pressure here and taken down. A sack back at the 7.
Not the first and goal play they drew up. Multiple defenders in to bring him down to the ground. Well, that's not how you hope to draw it up there on first and goal, CD, by taking a sack like that.
Well, they tried to be aggressive, didn't they? They didn't want to try and work their way past the goal line. They wanted it right there on that play. Unfortunately, it backfired against them. Now they have to try and pick it up here moving forward.
Hand off to Robinson out of the shotgun.
And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal.
Partner, I know we're in a goal-to-go situation, but my goodness, think about running the ball here. Not even a thought, is it?
Yeah, defensively, they're in a prime spot.
And I think the defensive guys are probably expressing themselves to them as well. I wouldn't run it here, guys. You might want to try throwing it.
And he's got it. And he takes it in. Touchdown, Washington. A 7-yard touchdown grab. And they are able to add on to their advantage.
A nice connection there, finding his target, and that'll put 6 up on the board.
Just like they drew it up in their playbook and reiterated it on the sidelines, right? Perfect route, a good throw into defense. They had no answer for that right there.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point.
And this one's right through to make it a 14-3 ball game. So that drive in total, 8 plays. And the result, a touchdown for Washington. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And he won't quite make it to the 25. The Carolina offense about ready to go. They trail now 14-3, an 11-point deficit as they start things out with a 1st and 10. Andy Dalton. And this throw will be intercepted.
Picked off by Benjamin St. Juice.
And he's able to get it back to the 41-yard line. Well, and I saw the pressure coming at him. That just looked problematic. Hit him as he threw it, and the interception ensued.
Let me pay homage to the man who stood in this spot before. He always talked about how much pressure is in the face of a guy. And can he step into a throw? And when you can't do that, oftentimes interceptions result.
So out comes Washington's offense to take over.
Well, these guys hardly got a chance to catch their breath after the quick turnover, but I doubt they're complaining much.
Especially with the field position they get to start with. I wouldn't be complaining either. I'd want to get right back out there and get after them, because now you have an opportunity to make a big play. I'd say let's be aggressive and go after him.
Throwing now is Daniels.
The 20. Big yardage there on the scramble. It gets him a 1st down.
We've seen the pressure get to him several times in this game. There, though, we see him escape it.
And we've seen this rookie video before as well. That type of pressure, oftentimes, what do you resort to? Your legs, try and escape. What you hope is that this doesn't become habit for him, that he learns how to handle the pressure, still keep his eyes downfield, and make some throws.
Daniels looking to throw. Here's a screen for Robinson.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. That'll bring up second and goal after the gain of 5.
The key to any screen play is all in the deception. And that means everyone on the offensive side of the ball. But someone gave it up because that one wasn't very well concealed. And the defense able to rally to him and hold him for just a short gain.
On second and goal, here's the option.
And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Washington.
Jaden Daniels
scoring on the 2-yard keeper as his guys are able to push that lead out a bit further. And maybe there that was just a case of completely overlooking the guy holding the football.
It certainly felt like it, didn't it? Because on my checklist, okay, as a defender,
QB's last.
Running back, fullback, heck, jet sweeps nowadays. Before you even get to thinking about the quarterback might actually keep it.
Seibert on for the PAT.
And it's 21-3. So they only needed 3 plays on that drive. And it's culminated by a 2-yard touchdown run. Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And they'll get him down inside the 30 at the 27.
Here's the Carolina offense as they get ready to take over here. And for this offense, Charles, you got to think kind of crucial here to put something together on this drive, because remember last time out, they threw the interception on the very first play.
And you can't afford to let this defense keep building any more momentum. They're playing awfully well, and they're awfully confident right now. To me, it's time to attack and take some of that momentum back. But make sure you're selective in doing so. Understand where you want to throw the football and make sure it's open before the ball leaves your hands.
And he'll be out of bounds across the 30-yard line. That'll go for a gain of 7, and that'll make it second down.
And his play caller does a nice job of giving him an easy throw to start this drive, and he takes advantage of it. The completion sets up a manageable second down.
Here's a 2nd and 3 now from the 33.
Here's Dalton.
He completes this one to Mingo.
Calling a gain of 3 on the play, and that's going to make it 3rd down and less than a yard. To throw here, Dalton.
The throw here, right sideline, falls incomplete.
The passing game not in sync here early, and now it's 4th down.
It's going to be another frustrating end to a drive here. This offense, they've not been able to get anything going in this first half, and now it's going to be time to gather on the sidelines and try to figure out what's going wrong. Who has an idea? Who has a plan? Time to implement it.
This will be a 41-yard punt, 3 on the return.
And the Commanders will take over with a 1st and 10. The Commanders' offense and Jaden Daniels getting set for this next possession. And this defense has got to be searching for answers right now. It's been his ability to make plays on the ground here in this first half that's really giving him fits. Out there, set and ready for this next drive, the Washington offense. And with a 3-score lead already, this is not time for a momentum change, so I'd imagine they'd be happy to just take this into the locker room.
And this turns into a nice gain with a slide at the end. Opted to run for it, the decision a good one, picking up the first, getting 14 yards on the scramble.
Partner, even I can figure out who deserves the lion's share of credit for their lead right now, because he has been terrific in a dual threat role, really chewing up yardage and getting them points with his legs. Simply put, that defense has had no way of stopping him, and that's why his side is on top.
Yeah. a treat to watch the rookie in that first half, the number two overall pick, Jaden Daniels. He had a touchdown both in the air and on the ground to help push his guys into the lead at the break.
All right, Coach, thank you, and we welcome everyone back for quarter number three. The Panthers going to get the football first, trailing here as well as we resume play in this second half. And they will wrangle him down a couple yards shy of the 30. But the Panthers going to take over here to start quarter number three. And you have to think, Charles, down three scores already, they need to play an almost perfect second half to have a solid chance.
And that absolutely starts with finding some way to put together a touchdown drive here. They need to be smart, fast, efficient, get the ball into the end zone, and do it again multiple times in order to have a chance to win this game.
Third quarter starts with a run by Hubbard. And they'll get it up just short of the 45 at the 44. That play going for 16 yards to start the drive, first down.
Sometimes it's hard to believe, but there are times this game is about patience, isn't it? Has had the game he expected, but that run there, that may get him going.
I was just
going
to say, maybe that gives him a little juice, because you're right, he struggled, especially in that first half.
Yeah, and I know the great ones always think to themselves, just hang in there. I'm just one big carry away from busting this open. That's a good start for him.
41 yards rushing for him now to this point.
Brandon, all things considered, they have to feel pretty good about getting that type of a gain considering the blitz that they just had against them.
Here now, second and four. From midfield here, Dalton. Short throw there, caught by Thomas. And he is across midfield from 149 to the other 49, a gain of just two.
Got to give credit where it's due. Really nice defense on that play. The pitch and catch was successful, but not any run after it.
This offense in desperate need of a conversion as they come up on third down. Throwing, Dalton. Work in the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they're going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at Washington's 35. A third down conversion with a strong gain of 14.
And that's the kind of play this offense needs to maybe kick them into gear a little bit. They've been stuck in neutral much of the game. Perhaps that can give them a little bit of confidence that big plays are out there.
Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move. First and 10. Dalton. That one complete to Leggett. And he's going to get this down near the 20-yard line. Just his second catch of the game so far. This one moves the chains. I don't know what they talked about at halftime. Whatever it was, it worked. They look like a different team here in the third quarter.
Yeah, I doubt that there are very many trash cans that got kicked over, that type of a speech. I think what they did was they analyzed what worked in the first half, what didn't, and figured out a better game plan.
Another chance for Dalton. And it's caught. And he doesn't quite make it, taking it within an eyelash. Dropped at the one. They go right back to him for 20 and a first.
I think he has to be saying to himself, how did that not wind up a touchdown? Remember, he just did the tip of the ball to cross the plane. It's not going to get there, but they're going to be set up in great shape with first and goal.
And Dalton to throw. Oh, he was hit as he threw it there, and that one winds up incomplete.
We're going to give out a little applause on that play. It has to go to the defense. More good work by them. They've taken away the passing lanes all game long, and you can see the frustration that it's causing because he just about threw that one into the first row.
Another shot from the one on second and goal. Hubbard is into the end zone for a Panthers touchdown. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today's NFL, a complete back. Three downs, stay on the field, run it and catch it, and he gets it done.
Pinheiro's extra point up and good. And it makes the score 21-10. So that drive goes 8 plays.
And it was Chuba Hubbard who finished it off with a touchdown run.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off.
And he's up across the 25 and down at the 28. First possession of the second half now for Washington. Now they were terrific in the first half, built up a sizable lead, and it's just been cut into a bit following the opening drive score on the other side. But this is a unit that has to be itching to get the football again.
You could say that again. They've got to be pretty eager because, let's face it, they've had to sit through halftime, then sit on the sidelines and watch that drive. So you can bet that they're saying, let's get on with this. We got to go out there and get some more points.
He'll get this complete to Sinek, the tight end.
And he'll be taken down, but not before they work it across midfield. Call that a very strong gain of 24.
That's another beautiful throw right there. Gets it to his man right in stride. And I think that throw kind of exemplifies what we've seen from this offense throughout this game. They've been in rhythm. They've been sharp. They've been on it. And they pick up another first down there.
On first and 10, it's Robinson. And a good job of finding the open space to run as he's down close to the 30 here. 18 more yards there and another first down.
Well, it certainly appears that the big guys up front have taken charge of the line of scrimmage. Two really nice plays back to back. But on the defensive side of the ball, there shouldn't be any despair. Okay, they've got us a couple of times here. Hang in there, keep your composure, and try and figure it out for the next play. Good throw, good catch, but I really like the route. The drag and being able to run away from defenders, hard to stick with them for that long.
Yeah, better against man than zone, or?
Better against man, because now you're running away from someone and you're not running into a defensive player in another zone.
Here's Daniels.
And it's incomplete. To give you an idea of how accurate he's been throwing the football, we're in the second half. That's just his second incompletion.
Well, if he's that locked in, that means everyone's locked in, because to me it's like throwing a no-hitter in baseball. The pitcher may get the credit, but a lot of people making plays behind him in the field.
Working out of the gun, Daniels.
And the throw there going to be incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare incompletion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up. Not that time.
Austin Seibert sets up for the field goal try. It'll be a 47-yard attempt from the left hash. Seibert's kick is good. And the lead grows to 14 and 24-10. So 3 points, response there to that opening touchdown of this third quarter.
And that's an important three, both in terms of adding to your lead, but also in letting the other guys know you're not going to just come out in the second half and take over.
After the made field goal, Seibert back out there to kick it away. And he'll be stopped up at the 25. Now the offense for the Panthers here, getting the football back. Right now, Charles, it just feels like they're trying to keep pace. They did score the touchdown last time out, but they still trail by double digits here. We'll see if this offense is once again up to the task.
Yeah, and I think that after the last drive, they've got to be pretty revved up, don't you think? Everything they were doing was working pretty well. They go back out there with the same mindset, play at the same tempo and the same pace. Still a lot of time left to make something happen in this one.
On first down, they'll start out with Hubbard.
And not much to speak of. Call it a one-yard gain up to the 26.
I think if they want to start getting back into this game, it behooves them to get better on first down.
Yeah, certainly not what they were looking for there out of the opening play of this drive. The last play got just a yard. Here's second and 9 from the 26. Passing, it's Dalton.
Got a man, that's Leggett.
So the completion results there in 9 yards. And they'll be faced with a third and inches.
They'll try and run for this with Hubbard. And he is going to have a Panthers first down, at least at first glance, as he'll spot the football just beyond the marker. They find a way to convert on third and inches.
I always appreciate runners who understand situations. That was just third and inches. No reason to dance around in the backfield and try and break off a bigger play. Just go pick up the first down, and that's exactly what he did.
First down, they'll stay on the ground with Hubbard to about the 40-yard line.
I feel like I could see what he was thinking on that carry. He wanted to follow that big tackle through the hole. Ended up only getting 4 yards on the carry. I think he had designs on that one being bigger.
Second and 6.
And motion left goes a tight end.
Short throw to the tight end, Thomas.
And they've got it well across midfield, down to the 40 before it's all said and done. Second catch for him today, and it'll wind up a first down.
You don't always expect tight ends to be big in terms of run after the catch, but after that play, he joins a growing band of players that's putting that stereotype right on its ear.
From their own 40 to the other 40, the gain of 20 leads to first and 10. Now Dalton, throw left side complete, that's Hubbard, and he's going to get this inside the 30. Back-to-back nice gains, that one for 14 yards and another first.
It's taken a while for this offense to get going, a little creaky at the start, but they're oiled up now. A nice throw there, and they're really putting together a good drive.
They'll run on first down with Hubbard.
And he'll be taken down after a minimal pickup, and that will take us to the end of quarter number 3. We have played 3 quarters. We'll return with more after this break. You're watching the NFL on EA Sports.
Back now at Commanders Field.
It's the Panthers in possession of the football, but facing a deficit here as we get to the fourth and final quarter of play.
Now second and 9.
Here's Dalton. Looking left side, and he's got a man. That's Hubbard. This will be a short gain of 3 before he's brought down at the 22.
One thing I think that's safe to say defensively, the tackling's been really good.
And because of that, it's been very, very hard for them to move the ball because you're not getting the benefits of run after catch. You're tackling them almost on the spot. That means you have to run extra plays, harder to move it.
On third down, he'll drop to throw. And he'll take this into the end zone. Touchdown, Carolina.
Deontay Johnson.
A 22-yard touchdown grab.
And the Panthers have made it a one-score game again here in the fourth.
Well executed there offensively. Defense looked a little confused, but he found his receiver, and that went good for 6 points.
And the payoff we just saw there tells us how many times they ran this play in practice over the past few weeks, because they executed that flawlessly right here on game day when the situation arose.
Pinheiro now to add the extra point. He's got it, and it's 24-17.
So a nice drive put together there. They go 75 yards in 9 plays.
And in the end, it was Deontay Johnson's touchdown catch to cap the drive.
Now after the touchdown, here's Pinheiro to kick it off.
And he'll be tackled just shy of the 25. Back onto the field now, the Commanders' offense.
That last touchdown has made this really tight. They're clinging now to this slim lead. Second half, they only have a field goal. This offense needs to kick it into gear.
And right now, I'm looking directly at the field general, at the quarterback. This, to me, he's got to take over right now by word, pumping his team up, and then, of course, by deed with his play. My high school coach used to say that all the time. Laddie, take over by word and deed.
And deed means action.
Exactly.
Now a handoff to start it out, Robinson. And he's going to get a good gain of 9 here up to the 34.
And that's just an ideal run to start this drive because they're in full ball control mode now. So if you keep ripping off 7, 8, 9 yards of carry, you're going to have a great chance of finishing off this game.
Maybe a good spot to take a shot here, 2nd and a yard from the 34.
Now Daniels.
And a dump off here to Robinson. And he's able to take this one up to the 35-yard line. 2 yards on the pickup, and that's all they needed to move the sticks.
But they certainly had success throughout this contest getting him the ball in the passing game, and there he picks up another first down. Whatever they saw going into this one, they've been able to capitalize on it, and no adjustment has been made to take it away.
They're unable to connect, but a late flag comes in. And the contact may have come too early. So the flag thrown for the contact, mark off the yardage.
And sometimes you just read a hitch route way too fast. You get there before you're supposed to, and there's a penalty.
Robinson up the middle. And he'll be taken down at about the 45.
Now, I'm guessing you'd say this is kind of the key here. Grind out some yardage, work on that clock, see if you can continue to tick it down.
Definitely. You want to bleed things out at this point, right? Continue to possess the football, gain some yardage, and put the onus on the defense. Do they have to use timeouts? What are they going to do to stop you? You're taking charge.
They throws it on the move but can't connect as that falls incomplete.
And when you're in a one-score game in the second half, now's not the time to force the football into places where you shouldn't. And that's a smart decision to just get that one out of there.
The offense on third down, they've hit 2 for 4 thus far. This will be 3rd and 6.
To throw is Daniels.
Slings this deep from McLaurin. And he bats it away, and it falls down incomplete.
Just because you've got the lead in the fourth, it doesn't mean you have to play it safe. I like the aggressive play call there to push it downfield. That time, it didn't work out.
Here's Tressway now, as he'll kick it away for the second time. This is taken at about the 14. It's a 40-yard punt, 6 yards on the return, and the Panthers will take over now, 1st and 10. The Panthers' offense here, they get ready to head back on the field.
And it feels like the momentum has shifted. They scored, then their defense forces that last punt, and now a chance to tie the game on this possession. Dalton and the Panthers now with a 1st and 10
at their own 20-yard line. They'll come out throwing here to start the drive. And that's going to be incomplete. Too tough to hold on to that one. It's 2nd down.
That sure looked like a nice call by the defense, and they're very cohesive in their coverage. As soon as he cut inside, they broke on the football and met him as the ball got there and forced the incompletion.
After the incompletion, here's 2nd and 10 from the 20. They'll bring a tight end in motion left. From the gun, Dalton looks to throw.
A short throw hauled in by Trimble.
They do get a couple, but they'll be left staring at a 3rd and 8 coming up.
The completion was given up, but that's why you play zone defense, so that you can have people around the ball when it's caught, and you don't give up much run after the catch.
An extra man here in the secondary for Washington on 3rd down.
So Dalton now.
That is caught,
and he's got it past the 30 before he's hit and dropped. That catch puts him over 70 yards receiving now as he's got a 1st down.
I like the design that we're seeing right there. This is what they need. Down by a touchdown here in the 4th. They just need to keep working their way downfield, and when they see openings, take their shots.
So they'll come up 1st and 10 now from the 33.
A give up the middle, Hubbard.
And he'll be taken down right around the 34 after a pickup of only a yard.
That felt like a trap because it looked to me like the opposing front was on that play from the get-go. They had everyone crashing the ball carrier before he even made the line, and they hold him to just a yard.
2nd and 9.
On the handoff, it's Hubbard. And again, he's going to be stopped up right at the line of scrimmage. No gain on the play there, so that doesn't help. Now they're looking up at a 3rd and 9 situation.
They've called his number a lot this afternoon. You wonder how much tread is left on those tires.
We certainly do, but I always think back to one of my favorite coaches in the NFL. And he used to have a meeting with his running backs every year in the offseason and say, look, as many times as you're going to carry the ball.
And now off to the races, down the right side. Touchdown, Carolina.
Xavier Leggett,
67 yards.
And the Panthers are an extra point away from tying this game here in the 4th.
And he showcased his blazing speed on that one.
Was he wearing football cleats or track spikes? Because he was gone. Big time play, and just think about what that does if you're a receiver on the team with him. Well, that's got to open things up for you as well, because if I'm a defense, I've got to get back deeper and deeper in order to keep him in front. But I'm not sure how many can actually keep him in front with that speed.
Pinheiro now to add the extra point. And we are tied here in the 4th quarter. Uh-oh, flag comes out here. This is going to be roughing the kicker.
When you're going back there on the kick block, you've got to go to the right point. That didn't happen. Ran into the kicker. The penalty flag had to come out.
Now this one setting up for a great finish. All tied in the 4th as the kick's away.
And they will not get a chance to return this one as it's through the end zone for a touchback.
Now we get another look at Washington on offense. They no longer have the lead after that last touchdown. All tied up in the 4th quarter. And a chance for this offense to mount a potential game-winning drive right here.
So 1st and 10 now from the 30. They begin the drive with Robinson.
And they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. 73 yards on the ground for him now on 9 carries.
Another carry for their leader and a good one. It's crunch time. They'll need him to continue to be productive in both the run and passing game in order for them to try and snatch a victory.
Clock running, under 4 to play now as they come up on 1st and 10.
To the air goes Daniels.
Trying to get their tight end involved finally. That's the first time that they've looked his way. He's kind of been a forgotten man in this offensive scheme.
Yeah, it didn't look his way at all in the first half. And I'll bet you the offense coordinator made a note at the half and said, let's get him involved because he could be a big-time playmaker for us.
2nd and 10. Out of the gun, they give to Robinson. And a good run here as he'll rumble all the way down to the 40-yard line.
That good for 19 and a first down. He continues to be effective running the football, a big reason that they have the lead.
And I love one of the quotes that I read about him where he said of himself, "I love it when a team just hops on my back and I just carry them along."
So from Panther territory now, it's first and 10 right at the 40.
Back to Robinson now on first down.
And he's going to get a solid gain of 9 before being brought down. Second and right at a yard.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. And I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there. I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently. And he'll lose yardage on the play back at the 37-yard line.
Well, I would have figured after the 9-yard run on the previous play, getting one more yard wouldn't have been much of a problem. But apparently it was, and now it's third down.
Getting down to the good stuff, all tied with 2 minutes remaining on EA Sports.
So it's Washington with the football here as we welcome you back.
And they're facing a big third down now in this tie ball game. Looking to throw, Daniels.
And oh, that's going to wind up incomplete. Nearly their first pick of the game, but it does bring up fourth down.
Oh boy, this sets up for a huge call now on fourth down because you can try the long field goal, you could go for it, or you could punt and play for overtime. I am so glad, partner, that I don't have to make those kind of decisions. Let's see what they decide.
And now the punter, Tress Way, as he sends this one away. And this one's out of bounds. Should be inside the 10, I think it is, at the 6-yard line.
The Panthers' offense and their quarterback ready to go once more. And we'll take you through some of the highlights here. You'll notice he had a hand in a lot of them so far. He's got this offense rolling right now.
The field position game, such an overlooked facet, Charles, of an NFL game, but this offense, they're going to be pinned back. What an ideal punt.
An ideal punt, and it leads to that term complementary football, because them doing that puts their defense in a great spot, doesn't it? Gives them a chance. If they want to be aggressive, try and maybe get a safety out of this whole thing, it puts them in that position.
The Panthers out there and ready to begin their next drive. Well, certainly they'd rather have the scenario they had last time. Now, Charles, remember, they had the short field. They took it in the end zone. Now this is going to have to be a longer, more sustained drive if they want to get points.
Yeah, a little bit more of a quick strike opportunity last time by where they were on the field, and you're exactly right about that. But now, backed up a little bit. What's that old expression we love to use? Time to matriculate the ball down the field and try and do it again.
Here's Dalton.
And he takes a shot on the release as this will be incomplete. Couple extra defensive backs out there in the dime, and because of that, really not many places to throw the football, if any.
And typically, what would you want to do against that dime?
Run the football.
You want to run the ball, but you can't do it in this situation. Not nearly enough time on the clock. You having to really navigate against a tough defense presented against you.
Dalton.
And that's going to be incomplete. The coverage too good there. The contact popped the ball free, and it's fourth down.
Well, the defense certainly did its job. They held up in that situation, and now on fourth down, you've got to punt this and try to get to overtime. There's no decision to be made, in my estimation.
Here's Johnny Hecker now, as he's on to punt for Carolina. Now a fair catch called for and made right on the 45-yard line.
The Commanders' offense and running back Brian Robinson getting set for this next drive. And it's hard to believe you could run the ball a whole lot better than he has. The vision, the cutback ability, the acceleration, it's all been on display throughout. This is first and 10. Throwing now is Daniels.
Sets up the screen to Robinson. And they'll get to him after a gain of 7 to the 47.
And Washington now going to use the first of their 3 timeouts
as they get it with under a minute to go now in the football game.
Here's second down. Daniels looking to throw.
Over the middle, that's complete to McCaffrey. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
Well, Charles, kind of the future of this franchise on display right there. You had a rookie throwing it, a rookie catching it, and taking it into the end zone.
Could you imagine if we were in the owner's box right now and we could look at the front office and see the grins on their faces to see the present, making plays, and knowing what the future will bring with these youngsters going out and making big-time moments happen for this team.
Here's Seibert now to add the extra point. And they will take a 7-point lead now.
Pretty clean and simple there. Just two plays, the long pass resulting in the touchdown on play number two.
Following the touchdown, here's Seibert now to kick it off. And able to take it past the 25 and up to the 28-yard line. The Panthers' offense and their quarterback headed out for this next possession. And this defense might be about ready to wave the white flag. Nothing they have tried to throw at him has been that successful. He just processes things so quickly and makes a right read seemingly every time. Here's first and 10. Now Dalton. Oh, and that's going to sabotage their comeback plans. It is intercepted. Picked off by Benjamin St. Juiced.
And he will return this one to the 30-yard line.
I'll tell you, Brandon, it seems like this guy's been all over the field so far. That's his second interception of the game. And so much of playing defense in the NFL, especially when it comes to defending the pass, is all about positioning and technique. And this is fantastic work on both fronts there.
The Washington offense set to take over.
And this game not quite in hand yet. We'll likely see all three timeouts defensively and then reassess where we are.
So first and 10 now from the 30.
Eckler now between the tackles. Stopped at the 24-yard line after a gain of 5.
Now the Panthers going to use the first of their timeouts as they stop it here with just under 40 seconds to go in the game.
Here's a second and 5. Straight ahead, it's Robinson.
And he's going to take this one down to about the 23-yard line. The Panthers going to use the second of their timeouts as the clock will stop with 34 seconds to go in the game.
The heavy set out there. Three tight ends in the formation for third and 3. Try to take this home. They'll run. And he will have a Commander's first down, and that should just about do it. Washington about to close this one out as they are down to a knee.
Listen, anytime you take a knee to end a game, that means you've won it. So it doesn't matter whether it's home or on the road, but there's something a little extra special about doing it in front of your home crowd, isn't there?
And the home crowd applauding. They're happy with what they've seen. Chalk this one up in the left-hand column for a win.
Yeah, that's right. Head to the locker room, throw the wristbands in the crowd for the kids, your gloves, your towels. Get to share it with the home team.
So it's Washington getting the victory here.
And we talk so much about the turnover battle, determining who wins, who loses. This game, no exception. Air-free football, no turnovers at all, and they win it.
So this is one you don't have to convince your team that what you're saying is accurate. And you know what I'm talking about. Head coach always stands up in front of the team and says, guys, if we do this, this, and this, we'll win. And usually they say, if we win the turnover battle, we'll win. Well, here's the proof right there. Win the turnover battle, go on to victory. Now the guys believe. You move on to the next lesson where you have to convince them. This one is now planted.
And for Charles Davis and our entire crew, I'm Brandon Gauden. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports.